Shri K. Ramamohan Naidu ji, apne speech kam conclude.
Thank you, Chairman sir. With your permission, I'd like to continue my speech. Chairman sir, according to a data published by the Education Ministry in 2019, out of 6,043 faculty members at the 23 IITs and 149, out of these, sir, 149 were SEs and 21 for STs, accounting for less than 3% of the total faculty members. Similarly, out of the 642 faculty members across 13 IIMs, only 4 belong to SC and 1 faculty member belongs to ST, sir. A similar pattern could also be seen in the University of Delhi, where out of the total sanctioned posts of 264, it has only 3 SC professors and none from the ST backgrounds. Furthermore, another set of recent data shows that there are glaring vacancies, sir, for teaching positions against the reserved category seats. As the data shows, the vacancy stood at 988 seats for SCs and STs, sir, against and 1761 reserved vacancies against OBC reserved seats also. So I'd like to request the Honorable Minister and the central government to take cognizance of this issue and fill the vacancy seats. Couple more points and I'll finish, sir. Sir, Chairman, sir, according to Global Innovation Index, India stands at 46th position, which is highly underrated for a country embarked on the path to become a superpower. Moreover, the budget that is allocated for the research-related departments is very, very tiny when compared with the total budget allocation. And on top of this, the government has slashed the funding for 3 major institutions up to 576 crores in the recent budget also, sir. During the pandemic, countries such as the UK, USA had an edge over us introducing vaccines on war footing, and this has, and we are also trying for Atmanirbhar Bharat. So my sincere request is to not cut the funding that is given to the R&D component, sir. Even for setting up this Gati Shakti University, the most important thing that we should concentrate on is the R&D budget for this. And other than that, regarding the AP Reorganization Act, there are a couple of universities that are to be given to the state. Sir, 1 minute, last point, important one, last point I'll conclude, sir. Sir, the TDP government ensured land allocation for these institutions according to the AP Reorganization Act. In spite of 8 years since the passing of the Act, the progress made on these universities is very, very slow, sir. For example, the IIPE, NIDM, ICER are still functioning under temporary campuses. So I would request the Honorable Minister to speed up the construction of these campuses and to hold the classes in their respective buildings, sir. And also, regarding the construction of tribal university also, sir, there is very little budget for that. And we have established in the tribal area for the welfare of tribal people, 56 crores against 1500 crores is not doing justice for this. So the central government should spend more funds on this, sir. With this, I conclude my speech. Thank you for the time, sir.
Mananiya Mantriji.